In the final video of this learning module, we're going to study the Intermediate Value Theorem. Now here's a statement of the theorem. We are talking about a continuous function. You have a function f of x that's continuous on an interval, and then you're interested in the value of f at each end, so f of a and f of b. You have a number somewhere in between f of a and f of b. Then I claim that there's a number c between a and b, such that f of c equals n. Now that's a bit of a mouthful, so let's draw a picture. Let's imagine we've got a function where f of a is negative 3 and f of b is 2. Now in a minute, I'd like you to pause the video and draw your own sketch of a function, of a continuous function that is negative 3 here and 2 here. Go ahead, pause it. Okay, welcome back. Now, I don't know what kind of function you drew. You might have drawn a curve that looked like that. You might have drawn a curve that looked like that. You might have drawn a curve that looked like that. But I'll guarantee you that in going from negative 3 to 2 continuously, you know, you didn't pick up your pencil because it was a continuous function, and at some point your pencil had to cross the x-axis. At some point you had to have a point where where the function value was 0. If this was your curve, then this is your value of c, where f of c is 0. If this was your curve, then this is the value of c, where f of c is 0. If this is your curve, then there are several values of c. But no matter what function it is, as long as it's continuous, to go from negative 3 to 2, you have to go through 0. To go from f of a to f of b, you have to go through n, because n is between f of a and f of b. The fact that we did positive and negative wasn't relevant. We could, instead of going from negative 3 to 2, we could have gone from 7 to 9, and we would have had to go through 8. We could have gone from 9 to 7, and we would have had to go through 8. That's the intermediate value theorem. So who cares? What good is it? Well, one thing that you did a lot in algebra class is find roots of polynomials. Find a place where a polynomial is 0. And I'll bet you never had to do one as ugly as x to the 4th plus x minus 3. Now, you don't have any formulas, or at least no reasonable formulas, for computing exactly what the roots are. But I claim that there's a root between negative 2 and 0, and another root between 0 and 2. And the way to see that is we compute some values. F of negative 2 is negative 2 to the 4th, that's 16, plus negative 2 plus negative 3, that's 11. F of 0 is 0 to the 4th plus 0 minus 3, that's negative 3. F of 2 is 2 to the 4th plus 2 minus 3, 16 plus 2 minus 3 makes 15. So what we've got is that at negative 2 we're at 11, at 0, we're at negative 3, and at 2, we're at 15. Well, to go from 11 to negative 3, you have to cross through 0. So there has to be a root between negative 2 and 0. To go from negative 3 to 15, you have to cross through 0. So there's a root between 0 and 2. The theorem says absolutely nothing about where the root is. Maybe it's here, maybe it's here. I drew it here. But it tells you that it's got to be there. One warning about the intermediate value theorem: only apply it to continuous functions on a closed interval. If you look at the function f of x equals 1 over x, you might be tempted to say, hey, f of negative 1 is negative 1. F of 1 is 1. So shouldn't there be a point where the function is 0 in between? And of course there isn't. The function isn't continuous. It doesn't go continuously from negative 1 to 1. It has an infinite discontinuity. It goes to minus infinity, jumps up to infinity, and comes back down. So the IVT does not apply to discontinuous functions, only to continuous ones.